फ्रेंड्स, वेलकम बैक टू द चैनल रुचिज टीचिंग. दिस इज रुचि हियर. इन दिस वीडियो लाइक आई वुड लाइक टू एक्सप्लेन व्हाट इज सी लैंग्वेज. इट इज अ पार्ट ऑफ द इंट्रोडक्शन क्लास ओनली. व्हाट इज सी लैंग्वेज आई एम एक्सप्लेनिंग हियर. ओके, it's a part of the introduction only. Before in our last class we have discussed about computer languages, generations of computers, all those things. And in this video, if I want to discuss about the C language, what about its features and about its translating programs and what is the purpose, all those things in a brief introduction, brief explanation I will complete it. Okay, before I start my video, I would like to just say that please, if you are newly watching my channel, please subscribe the channel, like the videos and share to your friends. Okay, then let's start. Now, what is C language? C language is a middle level language and it is a general purpose language. General purpose language. Third one, compiler based language. Fourth one, procedural programming language. And fifth one, structural programming language. Okay, why I am telling all these things is already we have gone through all these things, but I have kept it in one definition. You can call it in the form of a definition also. C language is a middle level language, general purpose, compiler based, procedural programming language and a structural programming language. Now all these I have been discussed, and this is the last part of the introduction of C language. So I just want to just give a brief explanation on each word. Okay, now I will take middle level language. Why I am calling, not only I, it's a word, it is a definition of C language. They have called it as a middle level language because it knows, who knows, C knows high level language and as well as low level language. How? Because when we have given high level language to it, computer, C software, it will convert high level language to the low level language, and again low level language to the high level language, it will convert and will give the answer. It will give the answer. So in this way, it knows high level and it knows low level. Okay, next. So that's why we will call it as middle level language. Now, it is general purpose. What is general purpose? General purpose is that means it's a multi-purpose language. What is multi-purpose? I will say that C language can develop. System softwares okay it can develop system softwares right and it can develop operating systems, it can develop PC or mobile games, can develop enterprise applications, it can develop databases. Okay, and it can develop embedded systems. Okay, and it can develop text editors. And can develop web browsers. System softwares are the softwares already we have discussed, like operating systems. So both are same. Operating systems like Windows, Linux and Mac, all these things it can develop. And mobile games means now you are watching the games on the mobile are all developed by the C only. Enterprise applications like banking systems and hotel management projects and insurance systems, all those things comes under enterprise applications. And databases are the like Oracle softwares, MySQL, all those things come under databases. And embedded systems means electronic devices, the software inside the electronic devices like fridge, washing machine, and like that, all electronic appliances. Now text editors are Notepad. Okay, next web browsers, you know, Chrome. So all those things can be all those things can be done by the C. That's why we'll call it as multipurpose. Okay, next is compiler based means it works, it can, the work of the compiler is what? Converting, it's a translating program. It converts high level to language to the low level language, or source code to the object code. Okay, so compiler means source code to the object code, it will do that work, and it is acts like the translator, right? Next, procedural programming language. Now these two are related, right? Now structured programming language, this derives procedural programming language. That means procedural programming language is derived from SPL. SPL is what? Structural Programming Language. Now, procedural means in the form of procedures, C languages are there, C language programs are there. This procedure, you can call this procedure as routine, subroutine, and routine, subroutine. Functions. So you can call these procedures as routine, subroutine and functions. So C language is called as either SOP, that is structure oriented programming, or POP, or procedural oriented programming. So C language has that word. Okay, and structural programming is it will, what is the work of the structural programming is, in structural programming, it will, suppose think that you have written a large program, large C program. What that structural programming work is, it will divide the program into smaller parts. Complex program has been divided into smaller chunks, and it will compile that each smaller chunk is compiled by the translator, and then it will give out the object code. And after the object code has been derived, it is all these chunks again it keep to the one place, and it will give the feed the computer or feed it to the software all together and give out the output in the whatever is the way you ask. Okay, so that is the work of the structural programming. Okay, so C language is also called as procedural oriented programming.